In this video, I'm going to describe how we calculate the pressure drop in a packed bed. And we often use packed beds as catalytic reactors where we fill a tube with catalyst particles. And we'd like the particles to be small, so we minimize the fusion limitations. But as we make the particles smaller, the pressure drop gets bigger, and we have this trade-off. We have to then decide which size particles are appropriate. So what we use to calculate the pressure drop, or the pressure as a function of distance down the reactor, is the Ergun equation. And the Ergun equation is written here, and I'm going to describe the terms and then what we have to be careful about in using the equation. So what we're calculating is the pressure, and we're calculating as a function of distance down the reactor. It's going to be a function of the diameter of the particles that we use in the packed bed. As the diameter gets smaller, the pressure drop gets larger. This is the void fraction of the bed, namely the fraction of the volume of the tube that is not occupied by the catalyst particles. Of course, the void fraction is also here in the denominator. And this is the cross-sectional area. And again, as the cross-sectional area gets smaller, the pressure drop gets larger. And then an important term is the volumetric flow rate. So we increase the volumetric flow rate, we increase the pressure drop. There are two terms in brackets. The first term is contribution from laminar, and the second is from turbulent flow. The same terms that we've just talked about, except for this one, this is the viscosity of the gas, and then we have the area again. This is a product of the mass density multiplied again by the volumetric flow rate. If we're talking about steady state, this is just a constant mass flow rate. And so we can substitute in the mass flow rate there. The volumetric flow rate that is here in the equation, however, is an important term that changes as we move down the reactor. As the pressure decreases, the volumetric flow rate increases. The important thing to keep in mind is using consistent units with this equation. So let's look at what units are appropriate. And we're going to use SI units everywhere. So the terms here, we have a mass flow rate, kilograms per second, the cross-sectional area, meters squared. This is dimensionless. This is also dimensionless, the constants. The void fraction is dimensionless. The viscosity has units of kilograms per meter per second, and the diameter also has units of meters. So we're adding two terms that have the same units. The void fraction, dimensionless. We have diameter in meters, area in meters squared, and a volumetric flow rate in meters cubed per second. So these meters cubed cancel. On the right side of the equation, we have kilograms per meter squared per second squared. And in SI units on the left side, pascals and meters. And the question first, is this consistent set of units? Well, a pascal we can write as a kilogram per meter per second squared. And then we have the units meter for the distance down the reactor. And we can see we have consistent units and SI units where we're going to calculate now the pressure in pascals if we use meters, seconds, and kilograms for our units. So a couple things to point out about this equation. It's a negative sign here because as we move down the reactor, and Z increases, the pressure decreases. The viscosity term is almost constant, but it's a function of temperature. It's not a strong function of temperature. Viscosity over viscosity at some temperature T0, typical type relation, absolute temperature, pretty much independent of pressure for all practical purposes. And so the one term that has a big influence is the volumetric flow rate. And so V, as we move down a reactor and the pressure decreases, then the volumetric flow rate increases. And the volumetric flow rate that we're going to substitute into this equation is going to be related to total molar flow rate, the gas constant, absolute temperature, and pressure. So the volumetric flow rate will increase because, one, the pressure drops, two, in a catalytic reactor, the temperature is likely to increase. And then the third way the volumetric flow rate can change is if we have a reaction gas phase where the number of moles change. So for example, A goes to 2B means for every mole that A reacts with, two moles of B, we're increasing the volumetric flow rate. If A and B were the only species in our system, we could write the volumetric flow rate in terms of flow rates of these two species. And of course, the volumetric flow rate could decrease if instead we had a reaction where the number of moles decreases. So in a catalytic reactor, we would solve this Ergun equation simultaneously with the material balance for the reactions and the energy balance for the reactor. And normally we'd end up doing that numerically.